Hello guys, today in Substance Designer Tips and Tricks, we're going to talk about the three most commonly used methods to create rims or edges for any shape. So let's get started. The first method is the easiest one. You only need to add an edge detect node. The main advantage is that you can easily control the width and roundness of the edge in a single node, which works nice with small values, but the roundness breaks with bigger ones, as you can see here with a square. This method is great to keep the corner sharp when you need a thick edge. To use it, you need to add transformation to the node, set the tiling mode to absolute and no tiling, and use a blend node with your original shape as foreground and the transform shape as background. Finally, set the blend mode to subtract. Now, if you scale the image in the transformation node, you can modify the edge width. Sadly, this technique has several issues. First, it is not procedural, so if you change the shape, it breaks. Second, it doesn't work well with shapes that have holes. And last, it also breaks if the shape is not pure black and white. So, while it is useful for some specific scenarios, usually you'll end up using other methods. The benefit is that compared to the other techniques, this one is really fast. The last technique is to use a blur node, which is a little bit more complex. To use it, you need to start by creating a levels and increasing the contrast till you get a black and white image. You can either move the top arrows of the level to the center, or click values, and type the same value on the three leveling parameters. I'll write 0.5. Now, you need to blur the image with a blur node. Next, we add another levels. In this case, we move the top three arrows all the way to the left, or we can set all the leveling values to 0. Finally, we add a blend node with the first level as foreground and the levels of the blurred image as background. Now, we set the blend mode to subtract, and the intensity of the blur will define the width of the edge. If you don't want sharp edges when using this method, you can use a blur HQ node instead of the normal blur. Just be sure to set up the quality to 1. In general, you get a better performance, especially if you don't use the Blur HQ. It's worth mentioning that while the Blur technique and the Edge Detect node will generate similar results with simple shapes, they will generate completely different ones with complex patterns, as you can see here. Well, that's all for now in Substance Designer Tips and Tricks. I hope you find it useful, and don't hesitate to comment or add questions below.
Good luck!